Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is erinkate and I'm a UX designer based out of Denver, Colorado. On my channel, I'm all about helping new designers and people that are interested in UX design transfer into the career field of UX UI design. I'm low-key obsessed with the job application process and hacking it, and I love giving people practical tips that are easy to put into practice so that you can get a job fast. In this video, I'll be sharing with you 5 super easy steps to help you become a UX designer this year, 2022. Let's do it. If you are familiar with any of my videos, my first step is just a no-brainer. It's to get Figma. Figma is a completely free design tool that is very, very popular in many big companies. I am based out of the United States, and I know that the tools that are used do vary, but I do see a trend that most companies are moving into Figma if they're not already utilizing Figma. Go to figma.com, set up your free account, and just start exploring. Go watch some YouTube channels. I'll get into another tip about Figma here in a second. For now, start exploring Figma, get accustomed to the tools, check out the Figma community, which is amazing, and just really focus your energy onto that design tool. Yes, a company might have some work in Sketch or some files in Adobe XD, but all in all, Figma will be an extremely beneficial skill for you to have on your resume, in your portfolio, and at the end of the day, these design tools are very similar and intuitive so that if you learn Figma, but you go work for a company that uses Sketch, it's gonna be pretty easy to go and learn Sketch after learning Figma. Figma is the first tool that I would recommend for new designers to get involved in. And the best part of Figma is that it's completely free. And that's what I love about it. Because when I first started learning, I was using Adobe XD and I had to pay for a subscription to that. I wish I had just started using Figma and just started for free. I wouldn't have had to make that investment. I wouldn't have had to remember to cancel my Adobe XD subscription. Super bad at keeping track of those. Get started with Figma. Tip number 2 is to take this Udemy course. So the name of this course is Figma UI UX Design Essentials. The teacher of this course, Daniel Scott, just really impresses me. I took his Adobe XD UX design course when I was first getting into UX design, and I didn't know that Figma even existed when I was first exploring UX design. I wish that I had actually taken his Figma course. His Adobe XD course was very helpful and really got me motivated and inspired to jump into a UX design bootcamp, and it helped me to make that decision to make that investment. I actually have a couple friends that have come to me wanting to learn UX design. One is a high school teacher, the other is still in college, deciding if she's gonna finish her degree. And I pointed them right in the direction of this Figma course because I told them, if you are curious if you're even gonna like UX design, boot camps are a really big investment. Go spend $15 on a Udemy course first. And truly, guys, like $15 is worth it to get your hands into a well-structured course with a good teacher and to learn if you actually like UX design. Whenever I say UX, just assume I'm saying UX, UI, or UI. UX. Okay, so with this course, and here's a sneaky little hack for you, what I noticed is that when I sent this course off to my friends, it was $14.99. But then when I was pulling the link on my phone back up a couple days later, the course was listed at $84.99. I started thinking, okay, so some type of cookies have been tracking me on my phone that I've been viewing this link a few times and sharing it around. Here is your hack to make sure that you get the best price possible on this Udemy course. So when you open Google Chrome, go to File, and down to new incognito window, and then go to udemy.com and search UX Figma. And his course is like, I think the second one down on my results. It is. I would say it's probably gonna be on the front page for sure for anyone's search, because this is one of the most popular and highly ranked UX Figma courses I'm finding on Udemy. While you're on Udemy, go ahead and take advantage of the website and just browse through the courses. See if there's some other courses you'd like to try out. If you do the Google Chrome incognito window trick, it's gonna bring up the lowest prices. I didn't go and search for like additional coupons to use. There probably are some out there, but I don't find $14.99 to be a bad investment, considering that like boot camps are like $5,000 to $10,000. It's a really good starting point. And one of the most important things to keep in mind when you're taking one of these intro courses is that you are deciding if this is even a good fit for you, because you don't want to get into something that a year from now you're going to not like and be burned out on. If you don't feel aligned with it, there's a lot of other career opportunities within the tech world that are probably worth looking at. Tip number 3 is a tip that I used a lot when I was in my early stages of learning UX design, and that was to look at job descriptions. For some reason, I found job descriptions to be highly motivational, because when you dig into a job description and you know, go through all of the text that's in that job description, you're gonna find keywords. And you can create like a Google Doc. Some people might go full out, make a spreadsheet, but I just created a Google Doc and I would copy and paste job descriptions, and I would essentially delete all the words that weren't keywords. And then by the end of that little exercise, I would have a list of keywords. And the keywords could be anything from wireframing to agile environment, Sketch, Figma, personas, user stories, user flows. So there are all these different keywords within UX UI design job descriptions. And what I did before I ever started my bootcamp, so while I was just kind of in the beginning stages of research, I took those keywords and I look up their definitions. So say it was wireframing, I would look them up within the UX context. So I'd say like UX design wireframing definition or UX design wireframing. And that was a really helpful exercise for me to help me get more comfortable with UX design vocabulary. And I could take those words and allow their definitions to paint me a visual of what those words really meant and what that would entail for me. You can go as far as to hop onto YouTube and look up UX design wireframing and then watch a brief tutorial on it. This tip is really one of my favorite pieces of advice because I think it's just so overlooked. You have all this information out there in these job descriptions. It's literally potential employers telling you, this is what we want from you. So take advantage of that. It's free and you can just go and educate yourself. And what I did, I took like the 10 top keywords, the 10 skills that I saw were most highly requested by different companies. And I made sure that I mastered those 10 skills from wireframing to personas to high fidelity or mid fidelity mockups in the sense that I got very, very familiar with what those design practices were. So I felt confident that I could properly execute them in my own designs and when I was talking about them in interviews. Tip number 4 is to do daily UI challenges. Now I'll go ahead and say I did not do a daily UI challenge. I feel like that's just kind of the buzzword for essentially the idea of going and finding UI challenges and practicing using your design tools and your design thinking process to fulfill the challenges. So that's really the context that I would look at this in. Some people might need that massive amount of exposure and practice to different projects and ideas, but what I find is I prefer to take a little bit more time on each project and give it a bit more thought. So I never tried to make myself do a daily challenge, but rather I used a UI challenge generator. I'm gonna share with you guys my absolute favorite. It's SHARPEN.DESIGN is like the domain. I just loved it because here I have it pulled up and I'll show you guys. I loved it because on Sharpen, it's not like a daily UI challenge. The first thing I'll say about if you sign up for a daily UI challenge is that your inbox will absolutely get bombarded. And anything that overwhelms me, I usually try to avoid. So when I have a daily UI challenge in my inbox and like I'm also working on my boot camp and I'm also living my life and I'm not doing them, and so every day it comes through and I'm like, I'm not gonna do that today, just don't feel it. It just kind of was demoralizing for me, so I unsubscribed to daily UI challenges and I went with Sharpen. The top part will be what you need to design and then the bottom part will be a description of what you're designing for. And what I really love about that is that you can toggle the locks. Say I really want to design what they're suggesting, but I don't want to design it for that population. I can go ahead and press new challenge and it'll switch up whatever's not locked. I just think it's fun. I like having options. And that's another thing. I'll be honest, I'm like defiant by nature. When I had daily UI challenges coming into my inbox and it was telling me like, design this, I was like, I don't want to. Maybe once every 10 challenges, I found myself being like, oh, that sounds really cool. I remember one time on Sharpen, it was like, design an art history app for a museum. And I was like, that's so cool. What I find with using Sharpen's design generator versus a daily UI challenge is that I get to use my creativity a bit more by, you know, toggling the locks on and off and mixing stuff up rather than just getting my email inbox bombarded. I guess technically tip number 4 is not daily UI challenge, rather it's use a UI challenge generator. Do that in your spare time. Don't feel like you have to do one every day. Maybe a goal of one a week would be a decent goal. Honestly, you could just use this once or twice to create a big case study because you could use the UI challenge generator to find a project for your case study. You need about 2 to 3 good case study projects for your portfolio website when you're getting your first job. Coming to Sharpen and using the generator to find a project is gonna be a really fun way to go about that. Tip number 5 of my easy steps to become a UX designer this year is to network. The very first way you can start doing that is by creating your LinkedIn account, or if you already have one, just updating it so that it says junior UX designer. Even if you haven't gotten through a boot camp yet, but you're planning on being a UX designer, I feel like you can put junior in your title. I know some people put like aspiring UX designer or amateur UX designer. I like junior UX designer because junior is often the terminology used in job descriptions. I just feel like it's a less vague title to use than like aspiring. Whatever feels right for you, go for it. On LinkedIn, just start connecting with people that are in the UX design world, especially if you're considering doing a boot camp. What I did, for instance, is I ran a search for people that were Career Foundry alumni, and then I added them to my network, and I even sent a couple people messages, essentially being like, hey, I'm really interested in Career Foundry's UX design course. I see that you graduated from their certification program. Could you give me some insight on how you felt about it, what you thought about it? And I did that not just for Career Foundry, but I did it for General Assembly and Springboard, and some people will get back to you, some won't, but you'd be surprised by the amount of nice people there are out there that are willing to help you because they've been where you've been. And it's just a nice way to connect. Some people here on YouTube might also take it as far as to say that that could lead to a potential job opportunity once you get your certification or once you, you know, have your case studies and portfolio built out. That wasn't the case for me, but I'm sure that that's possible. I think one of the main reasons that networking is so valuable for a new designer or, you know, aspiring designer is that putting yourself out there and just being able to start talking about UX design with someone that is further ahead of you in the UX design journey is beneficial for your mindset and for your vocabulary and those sorts of things. Another great way to network is Facebook. And I do have a favorite Facebook group for new designers. I will link in the description box below. Essentially, why I like it so much is new designers will pop in there and they'll ask questions, they'll vent their frustrations, they'll even ask for like usability test participants. So you get a good idea of what beginner designers are thinking, feeling, and doing. That sums up my video for today and the 5 easy steps to help you become a UX designer this year. It's little steps that will eventually help you achieve your bigger goal. And I find that deconstructing a big goal is very, very helpful to build motivation and to build confidence. So that's something that I really value doing, is taking the big goal, deconstructing it, breaking it down. And I did that throughout my whole entire UX design journey when I was going through the process of boot camp and landing my first job. And now I'm just really happy to be able to share that with others. If you found this video valuable, please give it a thumbs up. And if you're interested in more videos on how to transition into the career field of UX UI design, be sure to subscribe. I'll be sharing new videos here every single week to help you do just that. If you guys have any questions, also drop them in the comment section below, and I will do my best to answer those questions in my future videos.